Hello and welcome to this very special online gong bath. My name is Cathy Eastburn at Sarasa Sound and I'm recording live in London on the evening of Tuesday the 5th of May. I've been asked to create a special gong bath to bring some of the restorative and rebalancing spirit and magic of Kalukanda House to you in your home for charity. This gong bath is designed to help alleviate the stresses and worries of lockdown. And Dee has told me she's found my sessions very calming and positive during this time. And she's asked me to create something special that we can share with you. And if you're able, we would really love it and appreciate it if you could make a small donation to the charity Critical NHS, which is supporting frontline workers at St George's Hospital in Tooting in London. We do, of course, understand that these are difficult times, but even if you can spare just a few pounds, that will really make a difference. And you'll find a link to Critical NHS in the information where you found the link to this gong bath. So just before we start, just a couple of things. First of all, if you're interested in finding out more about gong baths in general, or the work I do with Sarasa Sound in particular, do go and check out my website, which is sarasasound.com. And secondly, just a suggestion that before you start listening to the gong bath, make sure you're somewhere comfortable and where you're not going to be disturbed for the next probably 50 minutes or so. And ideally, if you can listen to this gong bath through some decent headphones rather than through your speakers. So just a little introduction. This is really for people who've perhaps never experienced a gong bath before, just so you know roughly what to expect. So I've got here in my home studio four large gongs and a collection of Himalayan singing bowls and some quartz crystal singing bowls as well. I've also got set up today a bronze Javanese gunder metallophone and some other bits and bobs of percussion as well. And the sounds of these instruments, the gongs and the singing bowls in particular, are extremely resonant and full of very complex harmonics and overtones. And these sorts of sounds can be very therapeutic, both physically and mentally. Particularly good at helping to release blockages and tensions, whether they're physical ones or mental ones. And also these instruments, when they're played in particular ways, they're really good at helping us drop into a state of deep relaxation. And there's a lot of evidence now that shows how important it is to regularly experience that kind of deep state of relaxation, very important for our overall health and well-being. So the idea of the gong bath is I'm going to play these instruments for you for probably around 45 minutes or so. And all you have to do is just lie there with your eyes closed and enjoy it. And that's all there is to it. For this session, as we do every so often in my sessions, we're actually going to start off in a seated position. So don't get all comfortable lying down yet. We're going to start off seated with a very short, very simple, but really powerful process that I call guided observation. So we'll be doing that in a minute before the gong bath itself. And then at the end of the gong bath, we always have a few moments of silence, and that's a really important part of it, because that's a chance for us to start integrating and processing all of the sounds that we've experienced. And it's also a chance to spend a few moments really listening to our bodies, which is something I think is very important, and often we don't do it enough. During the gong bath, we may well get some extra sounds. They might be from my end. Occasionally we get a bit of traffic noise here. Not much plane noise at the moment during lockdown, but you never know. And we might get some extra sounds at your end as well. So we can actually incorporate all of those extra sounds into the gong bath and enjoy and appreciate them as part of the experience. And that's our choice. So I think that's all I need to say as an introduction. So we'll now do this very short, simple but powerful process of guided observation. So make sure you're sitting somewhere comfortable. Don't have to be cross-legged, but just make sure you're comfortable with your eyes closed. And spend a moment just coming into your body. So maybe just noticing where your body's touching the floor. Bring your focus to your breath. Don't need to do anything to your breath, just be with it, observe it. And now I'd like you to just think about what is perhaps getting in the way of positive flow in your life today, right now. What's getting in the way of that positive flow? And it might be something physical or mental or both. And just focus on that for a moment. And as you focus on it, notice where in your body you feel it. And notice what physical sensations you experience when you think about it. And now I'd like you to notice what it looks like. So if you had to describe what shape it was, what size, what colour, is it moving at all? What texture has it got? And as you focus on this thing which is getting in the way of positive flow in your life, what feelings do you have? What emotions do you feel? And as you focus on this thing, what thoughts come to mind? And they might be only half-formed thoughts, but notice them anyway. Now ask yourself, how does this thing get in the way of my day-to-day life? And now ask yourself, how does this thing get in the way of what some people might call your spiritual life? And now just take that bundle of feelings, sensations, thoughts, beliefs. Just take that bundle and gently put it on one side. And when you've done that, please lie down and close your eyes and make yourself comfortable for the gong bath. During the gong bath, you might want to just check in with that bundle of thoughts, sensations, feelings, every so often. Just check in with it and just notice what's happened to it. Is it still there? Has it disappeared? Has it changed? Just check in with it, but don't get latched onto it or distracted by it. Just a very quick check-in and then come back to enjoying the sounds. And if you find you can't check in with it without getting distracted or stuck into it, don't worry about checking in with it. Just lie there and enjoy the sounds. And you might like to start off by taking a few long, deep, gentle breaths. So gently bring yourself back to the space and notice the weight of your body pressing down on your mat or your sofa or wherever you are. Wriggle your fingers and wriggle your toes. Maybe have a little stretch. And now just check in with that bundle of sensations, thoughts and feelings, and notice what's happened to it. Is it still there? Has it changed at all? Has it disappeared? And if it's still there, ask yourself, what can I do now to help that process? And if it's disappeared, ask yourself, what can I do now to maintain that feeling? And when you're ready, you can open your eyes and slowly come up to a seated position. So I hope you enjoyed that gong bath. And I always suggest to people after a gong bath, if possible, not to eat or drink anything for about half an hour, just to allow your body a chance to really focus on processing all of the sounds. And then after that half an hour or so, please make sure that you stay really well hydrated for the next couple of days. So drink plenty of water, plenty of herbal tea for the next couple of days at least. And just want to thank you for listening to the gong bath, and I hope you've enjoyed it and found it beneficial. And it would be wonderful, just a quick reminder, wonderful if you can make a donation to the Critical NHS charity. The link is on the information with this link to this gong bath. So thank you so much and have a wonderful rest of the week.